everybody. Welcome once again. This is the fabulous Maybe Tomorrow by Teddy Bush from the brilliant TV series The Littlest Hobo, which I can remember as a little nipper when I was this big. One of the greatest theme tunes of all time. You let me know if you can think of any better. We have already covered this song. I will leave it at the end of the video on the left hand side for you to go and view, although we did sing it rather fast. We just listened back to it recently and we did rather get carried away and sing a little bit too quick and strum a little bit fast, which is still, after 4 years of playing the ukulele, is still something that I need to try and control while I'm singing and strumming. There's always something new to practice and learn. So we are going to teach this song as normal. Let's get the information you need in front of you. Boom, 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 and oh, an extra one, G minor, of course, and one strumming pattern, the island strum pattern, which we use quite a lot. You can learn this song and everything in it by following my song sheet, which will appear on the screen very soon, and you can just copy all the information and create your own song sheet. As usual with my teachers, if you're unsure about how to create a text document and create your own song sheet, then just watch my Learn Ukulele Free video, which will be in this top corner, and you will learn how to do it all completely free, as the office software is of course free to download. Just create all your own song sheets for free, like I have done for the last 4 years. You have a big collection of them and you can go back and relearn lots of songs that you've learned in the past. So you can pause the video, learn all that information. The hardest of the seven chords is the nemesis wrist swivel into B flat, which we sometimes just swivel and do half a B flat because we are a cheat. You can do whatever you like and whatever is comfortable for you to do. Let's now get the information back off the screen because we are going to learn the song. So, boom, 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 boom. There we are. I will now pop up into the top corner. My song sheet will be down there for you and we will learn the song together from my condensed into 2-page song sheet. We've got an intro as usual in block capitals at the top of the page and it's two full strum patterns in F. Down, down, up, up, down, up. And on the last down, up, we will be singing from the first line, there's a, before we change to D minor, above voice. So it'll be, there's a voice keeps on calling me down the road, and that's where I'll always be. That's how the first two lines work. Got a C above me, D minor above road, and another C above B at the end. That is, of course, two full strum patterns in D minor, in C, in D minor, and in C again. Two full strum patterns in each chord, but we only put a change where there is a change. And the next change is on the third line, of course, above the word stop. So we'll still be in C for the last down up of or every. Oh, every stop I make a new. Now it's just wrist swivel into B flat. Friend, can't stay for long, just turn around, I'm gone again. That's the full first verse. There it is, you can copy it. G minor above long, after the nemesis wrist swivel in friend, and then C above around, and F above again. Now, the hardest part of the song is the chorus, where we do two bold underlined chords, A minor 7 and D minor. You know what a bold underlined chord means in my song sheet? It means a one strum, A minor 7 and D minor, and it sounds like this in our highlighted yellow chorus, because we will repeat it of course many times in the song. Maybe tomorrow I'll want want to settle down. Until tomorrow, I'll just keep moving on. That is chorus. Very simple. Two lines to learn for the chorus, but it does repeat a lot, and that is the bit that you will struggle on. Just practice it over and over. Want to settle down. The good thing with the three changes, F, A minor 7, and D minor, is they're all right next to each other. Of course, A minor 7, you've got an extra finger on here. So we'll go from F, extra finger goes on to the third fret on the C string for A minor 7. And then that same finger just slides back one fret below the other finger on the second fret for D minor. So those three changes, F, can you see that? Very, very simple, because they are very close and easy to change to and from. Just practice it over and over. Down, until tomorrow, I'll just keep moving on. Now G minor. We struggled with G minor for a long time. Found it a really difficult chord to get into. The good thing with the G minor in the chorus is it comes after the one strum D minor. It gives you a little bit of time during your singing. Until two, because it's not until the second part of tomorrow that you will begin strumming again. So you go from D minor until two. See that extra time you get to jump into G minor. Of course, first finger drops down one. Second finger also drops down one, and the third finger goes in between the two on the E string on the third fret for G minor. And again, it's one you just have to practice, because you're used to G, obviously, G7, and then you go to G minor and it's a completely new kind of a G. But 1, 2, and 3, with a bit of practice, you will nail it. So then it is the second verse, the second half of which we repeat quite a lot. So we've highlighted the second part of verse 2 in blue to save us, of course, writing it all out again. We just know that we'll go back to that part of the song. So the second verse starts in same thing, exactly the same chords, D minor twice, C twice, first one above end, D minor twice above adventure, and then C twice above bend. Down this road never seems to end, when new adventure lies just around the bend. So if you want to join me for a D minor above while, just grab your two full D minors before the nemesis wrist swivel to B flat. Cat will travel like that's hobo style. That is verse 2. Just practice it, pause the video once you've seen the song sheet, once you've copied onto your own text document, created your own song sheet. Just practice that little section as we go through. Then of course it is chorus repeat. Maybe tomorrow I want to settle down. Practice it. We're not going to go through the chorus again, but we have put, of course, at the start of our song sheet, second page, chorus highlighted in yellow, and we'll go back and do it. Then we do second part, verse 2, highlighted in blue there, because we'll go back to that. So if you want to join me for a while, grab your hat, we'll travel light, that's hobo style. Of course, you won't have heard lots of the lyrics from this song, because it's mainly just the first verse and the chorus that repeat during the TV theme tune. But now you will find out how brilliant this song is, because the rest of the song we are going to be playing for you and you will be learning it. So after we've repeated second part verse 2, we'll go back to the chorus, which is highlighted in yellow there. But again, we are not going to repeat the chorus. It's there for you to already learn yourself. You've got your song sheet hopefully created by copying mine, and And next is a instrumental. Now we've wrote in second part and highlighted it in blue to show that it is the chords from the second half of verse 2. So if you just grab your hat, we'll travel like that's almost time. Don't sing that out loud, you've got to sing that in your head while you are playing the instrumental, which is just that little bit in highlighted blue. So after the highlighted blue instrumental, go back to the chorus. Maybe tomorrow I'll want to settle down. Until tomorrow, the whole world is my home. Whole world is my home. Different bit, different ending to the chorus. That's why we have put that in brackets there after the chorus, because it is a different ending. Which again you'll hear in the TV theme tune. It was different. It does have both choruses in there. And then we're going to the third verse, and this is probably the one that you've never heard before. And this verse is same as the second verse. You might not have heard this verse, so I will sing it to you if you haven't heard my cover of the song. There's a whole world waiting to unfold, a brand new tale no one has ever told. We've journeyed far, but you know it won't be long. We're almost there and we'll pay our fare with a hobo song. Then we'll go back into the chorus. Now for this chorus you could actually use either chorus, just keep moving on, or you could repeat again. The whole world is my home. Up to you, your song, you do it any way you like. And then we repeat second part of verse 2 again. So if you want to join me for a while, just grab your hat, we'll travel like that's hobo style. Then the big finish. And it is the chorus again, but completely different altogether. You most likely definitely have not heard this part of the song. And it finishes the song absolutely brilliantly. The outro is the chorus, but with a big difference. And it is, maybe tomorrow I'll find what I call home. Until tomorrow, you know I'm free to roam. That is the song, complete and learned. Hope you've enjoyed learning this brilliant TV theme tune. Definitely, in my opinion, the best one of all time. You know what to do if you have. And of course, there will be lots more to come during summer 23. We will do another couple of covers. And we will teach some songs of the past too. But we've got another song in the bag. Hopefully you have created your own song sheet and you can practice away with that song. Didn't we do brilliantly to condense all of those repeats of choruses and verses and second part verses and different types of choruses all onto 2 pages? We thought we did fantastic. But that's the whole idea. It means you can have that 2 pages in front of you to just play away and practice and learn the song in no time. So that's it from me for now. Until next time. See you later.